Hello, good day to all of you. So in this video lecture, we are going to learn about the sunspots and how many types of sunspots we have and what is the source of sunspots. And finally, we will look at the effects of the sunspots on the Earth. So before going to the lectures, we have some learning outcome. So the first learning outcome or the objective is to learn and understand the sunspot and the cause of higher sunspots activity at the sun. And the second learning outcome is we will know what are the effects of the sunspots on the Earth. So let's start with the understanding what is a sunspot. So sunspot is actually a temporary phenomena on the sun's photosphere, which is the layer. I mean, if you want to understand the photosphere or the atmosphere of the sun, so you can refer to my previous lecture. So these activities are going to be held in photosphere, and these appears to be a darker spots than the surrounding area. So on the right side figure, you can see this is the surface of the sun, the photosphere, and you can see the darker portion, which is over here. So what are these darker portion is actually the area of the reduced surface temperature caused by the magnetic flux concentration. So that inhibit convections. So you can see the convections produced from here and it goes up to here. And these sunspots normally appears in a pair in the opposite magnetic polarity. So there's another figure which shows the sunspots. So you can see this is one of the sunspots. Actually, there are multiple sunspots in this region. Over here, this part and this part. And also there is some other scales of the figures which shows the sunspots like this. So this is the photosphere or the surface of the sun. Then these are the sunspots which looks like this one. And if you want to understand the size of the sunspots, so these are not very minor. So most of the time they are quite bigger. So you can see there are some sunspots which are actually larger than the whole size of the Earth. So this is approximately size of the Earth. And you can see a sunspot which is quite bigger than the Earth. So there are also some types, or maybe you can say the classifications of the sunspot based on their magnetic field. So the sunspots comes in all size and shapes, as I mentioned. So some group of the sunspot have more complex magnetic structure than the sunspots group and are more likely to produce the solar flares. So there are different classification. So the first classification of the sunspot is called the alpha, which belongs to a unipolar sunspot group. Then after that, we have the second group, which is called beta. And this sunspot group that has positive and a negative polarity, or a bipolar, with a simple division between the polarities. Then after alpha, beta, then we have the third one is a gamma. So it's a complex region in which the positive and negative polarities are so irregular and distributed that they cannot be classified as a bipolar sunspot group. Then the fourth one is beta gamma. So it's a combination of the second and third classification. So in this, actually, we have the bipolar sunspots group, but complex enough so that no lines can be drawn between the spot of the positive polarities. Then after the fourth one, beta gamma, then we have the delta. So this is the group or the classification, which is ambery of the opposite polarity in a single penumbra. And the sixth type of the sunspot is beta delta. So this actually the sunspot group with a general beta gamma, general beta magnetic configuration, but contain one or more delta sunspots. So I mean, it's a combination of beta and delta. Then the seventh one, which is the second last classification of the sunspot, is a beta, gamma, and delta. So these are a combination of these three. And these sunspots groups with a beta, gamma magnetic configuration, but contain one or more delta sunspots. Then finally, we have the eighth classification of the sunspots, which is gamma and delta. So the sunspots group with the gamma magnetic configuration, but contain one or more delta sunspots. So these are the classifications of the sunspots. Now you will be thinking that how we can look at the sunspot and what are the temperature of these sunspots. So there's some studies or the saying that the sunspots can be visible from the Earth without the aid of telescopes, but normally it's happened when we have the solar eclipse, during the solar eclipse. And if you look at the temperature of the sun, so it is actually 5800 Kelvin. But when there is a sunspots like this black spot, these black spot, so the temperature of these sunspots is 4000 to 4500 Kelvin. And if a sunspots were isolated from the surrounding photosphere, I mean, from this part of the photosphere, it would be brighter than an electric arc. So now we'll be looking at the number of sunspots activities yearly. I'm showing you the data from 1760 to 2020. So right here on the y-axis, we have the monthly sunspots numbers. And on the x-axis, we have the times, which is in years. So it's a start from 1760 to 2022. So you will be observing that you can see after a certain time, there is a peak of sunspots activity, then it goes down. Then suddenly it goes up, down, up and down. So if we calculate the years, how many years it takes to go up and down, so it's almost 10 to 11 years, like 1780, then some 1760, 1770, 1780. So it's almost 10 to 11 years. So as I mentioned in my previous lecture, that the sunspots activity or the sun magnetic fields is actually flip in 11 years, roughly 11 years of the time of the Earth. So now we can say that this is proven that every 10 years we have the sunspots activities higher and then it fall down. So let's look at the data, which is quite close. Let's say it's in decades. So from 2010 to 2022, recent data. So in this data, you can see from 2010 to 2020. So you see in between 2010 and 2020, we had the higher sunspots activity, which was in 2014 or around to 2014 or 15, like this, we have the higher sunspots activity. So during that time, you will be looking at there is some effects which has been observed on the surface of the Earth. I'm going to discuss that in later on. So now, right now we are here in 2022, which is today is July. So you can see that the sunspots activities are gradually increasing, and the maximum sunspots activity which will be recorded, it will be around 2025. So now we look at the daily sunspots activity, which is from the very recent data, which is from last month to today. So you can see there are a lot of sunspots activity, which is starting from 27 May. So you can see these activities was below 40. Then suddenly it goes up to 70 then if you look at the middle or the start of the month, so you can see number of activities are increasing and decreasing. So it's not the constant, but they have a certain range based on the whole year data. So if you look at the activity, which is, I mean, the today, so today or the yesterday activities was quite high. It was about 80 sunspots activity per day. So from this slide, you can observe that every day there are number of sunspots activities are being held on the surface of the photosphere of the sun. So this is a graph which is taken from some solar space, solar cycle. So over here, they have forecast the sunspots activity, which will be gradually increasing. So I have shown you the data from 2010, but now we'll be looking from the recent data up to the 2 year after that. So now here you can observe that the sunspots was quite low in 2020. Then in 2021, it's gradually increasing. Then 2022, which is now. So we can see a number of activities goes up to 160. So the green line actually shows the daily activities or monthly activities, actually. The summary of the monthly activities, which has been increasing. So if you look at the next year, which is 2023, so you can see these still remain the higher solar sunspots activity. So if you look at the 2024, so the prediction is that, or the forecasting is that, the sunspots activity is going to be higher and higher. So as up to the 2025, there will be a lot of sunspots activity. So why we are studying these sunspots activities? Because these actually effects on certain equipments and certain life parameters which we are going to use in our daily life. So what are those? So these are the equipment or the summary or the effects of sunspots on the earth. So as I mentioned that when we have the more solar flare, then there will be a more sunspots activity. So which means the increasing of the geomagnetic storm activity for the earth. So this is shown in this figure. It's not the real scale, but you can see this is the sun and this is our earth. So when there are some sunspots activities, then what are the things will be affected by that? So as a result of sunspots activity, the earth will experience an increase in the northern and southern lights, as well as the portion of disruption in the radio transmission and power grid. So these are some examples. So you can see the sometimes it can damage to the spacecraft electronics and also the solar flare protons, which comes into this. And actually these transmission we use for the air travel. So the radiation effect on the avionic systems. So as I mentioned that the sunspots have a lower temperature than the rest of the sun, but still the many scientists believe that when there are a lot of sunspots, the sun actually gets hotter. So it means the temperature will increase. Similarly, if there were more sunspots, the earth might get hotter and there might be less rain and would be result in more drought on the earth. So it means from if we have the more sunspots activity, so it will become more hotter, the sun. So because of the hotness of the sun, so the effect will be here. So then there will be less rainy. But as regard the today, if we look at 2020 or 2022, so we have less sunspots activity. So because of that, the temperature is gradually decreasing on the surface of the earth. So that is also one of the reasons That's why we have the global climate change. So it's happened most of the time in every year. So if you remember in your life, like 2013, 14, 15, so this time was quite hot in the region where you are living. So as a summary of this lecture, so we have looked at the sunspots, how to observe, and what are the size and temperature of the sunspots. And we have also looked at the daily sunspots number. And obviously we have looked at the forecasting of the future sunspots activities, and also the effects. What are the effects of these sunspots on the human equipments? Okay, that's all. Thank you so much. I hope you have learned the sunspots and how they affect on our daily life. Thank you so much and have a good day.